Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released macOS Big Sur 11.3 to the public. This is available to all macOS Big Sur supported devices and is available around the world at the same time. Now, as you can see, it was 5.71 gigabytes. That's on my Mac Pro. It can vary from about 2 to 3 gigabytes, all the way up to 12 gigabytes, depending on the version you're coming from. If you're on macOS Big Sur 11.3 betas or release candidate, the release candidate is the exact same version as this version. Uninstall your beta profile or beta install profile, and you'll be able to just have the normal version. There will be no update for you. Let's go ahead and close this. We'll take a look at the build number and then talk about what's new. So we'll go to the Apple in the upper left, then go to About This Mac. And as you can see, it says macOS Big Sur version 11.3. If we click on it, you'll see it says 20E232. This is the current version of macOS that's available now. Now, if you're not seeing the update, you can go to Software Update here. You can also go to Software Update in your System Preferences, and then by clicking on Software Update, it will check for a new update. If it's not showing up, click on Advanced, click OK, and check again. It will generally show up after maybe a couple tries if it doesn't show up initially. Now, this update has a few significant changes in it, actually quite a few changes in it, and this was released along iOS 14.5, iPadOS 14.5, tvOS 14.5, and watchOS 7.4, and also HomePodOS 14.5. A lot of updates came out at the same time. Now, the first change here is if we click on the Service tab at the top, and I got to this again by going to Apple and then About This Mac, click on Service. And under Service, if you don't already have Apple Care Plus, you'll have the option to subscribe to it or add it to your Mac. Once you've added it to your Mac, it tells you when it expires. In my case, it's December 15th, 2022. And then you can get support and see details. It gives you all of your information here. They've changed this around compared to previous versions, for example. So it's just a little bit different here. Now, if we close this, one of the first options or first changes they've made is if you have HomePods Mini or HomePod Mini, click on the little icon here, you can see that it says Office Desk, and that's because I have two HomePod Minis in stereo pairs. So you can now use this as an audio source. It is a little bit laggy. If you were to watch a YouTube video, for example, it sort of lags behind, but once it's playing, it's just fine. So you can't use it to edit a video, but it is a nice option to listen to audio through. So it's there if you have a stereo pair of HomePod Minis. Now, the next thing is Apple has updated macOS 11.3 to support AirTags. The new AirTags that were announced now work. If we go to Find My, you'll now have a new tag that says Items in Find My. And if you've added AirTags to your iPhone, for example, they'll show up here. You'll see it says Keep Track of Your Everyday Items, Add Accessories or Other Items that are compatible with Find My, and they will appear here. So if you have those items, they'll show up here, as well as third-party items, such as maybe a bicycle that supports Find My. So third-party developers or creators can make different products that support this as well. So that's available in Find My. We'll go ahead and close that. And there's some additional updates specific to the M1 Mac. So we'll talk about those and then talk about everything else as well. Now, as you can see, I'm on the M1 MacBook Air. And one thing all of the new M1 versions of MacBooks get, or Mac Mini, is a hibernation mode to save more power. So that's something they've added in this update. Now, additionally on this update, if you're using iPhone or iPad apps, which you can do only on M1 Macs, there's some new options. So if we go into Launchpad, go to this one in particular, we'll just open it up since I know it works. Wait for it just a moment. And if we go in the upper left, click on Modern Ops, click on Preferences. We'll open up Preferences and you'll see we have some new options. So we now have the option to make the window size smaller or larger. We also have touch alternatives, so we can use the keyboard for things like the controller, for example, or just sort of motion control using your trackpad if you have one of those. And you also have the option for game control. Again, you can assign your game controls to different locations on the keyboard. So as you can see here, we have X, Y, R1, B, for example, assigned to different keys on the keyboard, and then you can use the trackpad. So you have that option on the new M1 specifically, nothing else. So you have all of those. Now we also have the option to make an iPhone or iPad app full screen. So if I go into Overcast, for example, and we have sort of the iPad version, we can click on this button here and make it full screen if we want to do that. That's a new option in here as well, specific to the M1 style Macs. Now, just like iOS 14.5, if we go into Messages, we have new emoji. This is to comply with the new Unicode 13.1 standard. There's a total of 217 new emoji. You can see some of them here, head in the clouds, heart on fire, and Apple specifically says that there's support for separate skin tones for each individual and all variations of the couple kissing emoji and couple with heart emoji. Also, there's new face emojis, heart emojis, women with a beard emoji. So that's specifically what they say, as well as you can see there's a syringe, and headphones now look like AirPods Max. So those have all been added. That's just to comply to the Unicode standard that's available on other devices as well that are not iOS or Mac. So we'll close this, and there's some new additions to Siri. If we go to System Preferences and then we click on Siri, under Siri, we now have four different voices. You'll see if we go to Voice 1, I'll have you hear each one of them.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
So that has been added to this particular version, and you can also have it listen to Hey on the headphones and respond to phone calls coming in using Siri as well. So they've added all of those, and it will not default to one of these voices upon startup as long as you're not signed into an Apple ID. If you're signed into an Apple ID, it will remember what you selected previously. Now, another change they've added has to do with the new iMacs they announced. Now, you can't see this specifically right away. You have to add it if you don't have an iMac, and I'll leave instructions on how to do that in the description below. But if you go to Desktop and Screensaver, click on Screensaver, there's now a new Hello Screensaver, and there's some options here. So if we go to Screensaver Options, you can see Soft Tones, Spectrum, Minimal, or All. And it says show hello in all languages and match system appearance. So that's something new. You'll see there's all the different colors there as well. So that's a new option within screensavers. But again, you have to add this if you don't have a new iMac. Now Apple Music gets some updates. So we'll go into Music, and mostly we'll click OK on this. I have the volume turned down, and something they've done is make it more consistent with iOS, for example. So if we go into this album here, and maybe we'll play this song here, and we'll click on the three-dot menu in the upper right, you can see playing next. We now have the infinity symbol for autoplay. It will keep playing similar songs and just keep going as you're listening to music that's similar to it. So it will pick the next song and just keep going until you tell it to stop. So that's something new, similar to what we have on iPhone, for example. Now, another change they've made has to do with city charts. If we go to Browse, you can see these here. So chart toppers in cities around the world. So you've got New York City, Los Angeles, Miami, Houston, San Juan, and we'll just keep going all the way over to Berlin, Barcelona, for example. You have all of these options, and there's even more from around the world. So this is something new within Apple Music. Again, they've added things to make this a little bit more consistent with different icons for different songs you might want to download. So you have new download symbols, a similar menu to what you have on iPhone, for example. It's just very consistent across everything. And the same thing carries across to podcasts. You'll see podcasts is loading here. If we go to Browse, we'll wait for it to load, and you have just a slight redesign. If we go to Listen Now, maybe go to this podcast, the show page is a little bit different. They've redesigned the overall show page to make it a little bit easier to see and easier to follow along. So that's something they've done. Also, you have options to save and download episodes automatically after adding them to your library. So maybe you're following someone. If you go to Podcasts and then Preferences, you can now download episodes when saving, automatically delete played episodes, and you also have the option to hide played episodes if you don't want them to show up. So they've updated some of that, as well as automatic downloads under General as well. So all of these things are available within Podcasts. I think it's very helpful as Apple is adding subscriptions to podcasts as well. We haven't seen that turned on just yet, but that is something coming soon. Also, there's top charts as well. So this is new. There's top charts for all the different categories. And if we go to search, we now have categories as well. So they're in rectangles. Again, very similar to what we have on iOS now, if you go into the podcast app. So you can go into comedy, for example, and see all of the comedy podcasts. They're just making it a little bit easier to navigate and, again, adding consistency. If we go into news, there's some updates if you have News Plus as well. So if we go to News Plus, for example, under News Plus, they've redesigned the overall look of it, and it just makes it a little bit easier to find things that you've subscribed to, such as magazines or newspapers and your downloads, for example. So it makes that a little bit easier to browse, and then you've got some options in the upper right for sorting. So those things are new here. Also, if you go to search, you can now search by category or interest. So I use the same example in the iOS video I did, but if I search for cars, you now have that as a topic you can search. It will find anything related to cars in both news and magazines as well. You could search for music if you'd like, and you can search topics based on music or music festivals, music videos, for example. So all of these things have been updated within the news app. Now, with all of the privacy that came to iOS, that carries across to macOS as far as Safari. So if we go into Safari, now within Safari, they've now given us the option to customize what we see here on our start page. So we have our frequently visited and privacy report and things like that. But if we click the menu in the bottom right, and maybe we want to move privacy report to the top, we click and hold and drag to the top. Now it's at the top. We can do the same, move it around wherever we'd like, turn sections off if we don't want them there. So we can have the option to turn them on or off based on what we'd like. There's also additional web extension APIs that let developers offer extensions that replace the new tab page. So you can have different extensions that use more features, as well as speech API that lets developers incorporate speech recognition into their web pages for real-time captioning, dictation, and voice navigation. So that's great for accessibility. Also, they've added support for WebM support as well as Vorbis audio. So if you have WebM video, you could play this video here if you wanted to. And that support has all been added within Safari with macOS 11.3. Now let's go ahead and close this and head over to Reminders. Under Reminders, we'll wait for it to open. Now within Reminders, if we click on today, we can now sort our reminders. So if we click and drag, we can move them back and forth. Maybe we have a bunch of different ones. We'll have that option as well. That's very similar to what we have on the iPhone again. And also we have support for syncing across all of the devices as well, if it wasn't working properly. So it will sync not only your reminders, but the order of the reminders in the list across the devices. So it should sync more completely this time around. Also, you have the option to print reminders. So if maybe you have a ton of reminders, you can go to File and Print if you select those reminders. So if you want to do that, you have the option now. Another thing they've added support for is something people have wanted for a very long time. That's Xbox Series X and Xbox Series S wireless controller support, as well as Sony's PS5 or PlayStation 5 DualSense controller support. So if you want to use those to play a game, you have the option to do that now. Now, as far as anything else, there's small changes throughout with consistency, like I said, but they have fixed some things as well. And one of those things, again, has to do with reminders. Specifically, when you create a reminder via Siri and maybe unintentionally sets it for an early morning hour, that will no longer happen. Also, if you have iCloud Keychain enabled, maybe you're using your iCloud Keychain and you want to turn that off, sometimes you wouldn't be able to do that before. You should now be able to do that. And then automatic switching of AirPods should now work properly. That's something people have been having issues with for a while, and that should work properly now between devices. So not only that, but also the notifications for switching between devices. So maybe you're switching your AirPods Pro between your Mac and your iPhone, that should now switch properly. And the device notifications will pop up once and not be duplicated. So all of those things should be working now. Also, external 4K monitors should show the proper resolution if you're using USB-C now. And then specifically on the Mac Mini, the M1 Mac Mini, the login window sometimes wasn't showing properly after restarting the Mac Mini. That should work properly as well. And then also if you're using Dwell with accessibility, maybe you're using the accessibility feature specifically for that, it should now work properly in the accessibility keyboard. So that's fixed within this update. Now, other than that, Apple has updated security as well in macOS 11.3. So if we go to Safari and we're at Apple's security updates, you can scroll down and see all of them from Safari to iCloud for Windows, but we'll go to macOS Big Sur 11.3. And if you want, you can look through all of these. I'll link them in the description, but you can see there are a ton of security updates in macOS 11.3. So all of these apply to this particular update. And so that leads me to, should you update to macOS 11.3? I would say absolutely. It's working fine for me in things like Final Cut Pro, for example. So I've had no issues with editing. I've been using the betas all along and it's working okay, especially with the release candidate and the final version, and it's working just fine. So no issues there with any of my apps. I don't know if that carries across to all audio apps, for example, but so far I've had no issues with the audio apps I use. So right now it seems to be working okay, and I would definitely recommend installing it. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on the iPhone version of this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.